Michigan huddling on this side, Oklahoma across the way. Ohio State was beaten this afternoon, and there remains the plague. And I'm sure that the Boomer Sooners figure that if they win, they will be voted the national champions.
I'm sure they do, Jim. As I mentioned earlier, it can take two or three different twists. We're looking at Barry Switzer. He's got a smile. I don't know if that's the indication of his feeling about the game that was just over. Bo Schembechler, I know, is just as interested in the outcome. But what I did mention is that it can take two or three different turns when you already know going into a ball game that you have a chance to get into and be a national champion. If you put your attention on the ball game, everything goes fine. If you put your attention on the importance of what it means to win the ball game, all kinds of things can happen, and I think we'll get a pretty good look at it in just a minute.
All right, Tony D, as they call him out in Oklahoma land, Tony DiRienzo, who came from São Paulo, Brazil, to Ardmore, Oklahoma, in his senior year in high school as an exchange student, will kick it off. And the deep man for Michigan will be number five, Gordon Bell, who during his career in 1975 carried the ball for 1,385 yards to lead the Big Ten. And Bell has been averaging about 26 yards per kickoff return. His number is five. He is in the middle. They'll try to get the ball to him. Everybody's on their feet. And the 1976 Orange Bowl game is underway. Gordon Bell in the end zone and will down it there. He'll come out to the 20-yard line, first down and 10. Rick Leach, number 7, will be the quarterback. Gordy Bell, number 5, the tailback. Rob Lytle, number 41, the fullback. Your split end, Keith Johnson, 27. Your wingback, Jim Smith, 37. Your tight end, 82, Mark Spurge. Steve King, 67. Bill Dufek, 73, your tackles. Mark Donahue, 60. Walt Downing, 72, the guards. Jim Sear, 52, at center. First down from the 20. Gordy Bell, and runs right into the left side, led by Mike Phillips, number 89. Mike Phillips, 89, and then those Selman brothers, Leroy, 93, the Outland Trophy winner, Dewey, 91, the nose guard, Anthony Bryant, 71, Jimbo Elrod, another All-American, at right end. Three All-Americans in that front five. Jamie Thomas, 38, Bill Dahlke, 40, are your linebackers, Sidney Brown, 21, Jerry Anderson, 17, your corners, Scott Hill, 7, Zach Henderson, 1, the safeties. Second down, 9. This time it is Jim Smith. Smith has the first down, riding up to the 35-yard line. First down from a 35. This is Leach pitching back to Bell, and excellent coverage by Mike Phillips. Rick Leach. Leach throws the ball. It is intercepted by number 7, Scott Hill. The first turnover of the ball game, and Oklahoma will have the ball at midfield. 12-42, Elvis Peacock, 4 in that wishbone. Second man through is Jim Luttrell, the fullback. Victor Hicks, 80. Check that. That was Joe Washington, number 84. Tinker Owens, number 11, the split end. Carl Baldeschwiler, 67. They call him the USS Vaughn. Mike Vaughn, 79, the tackles. Evans and Webb, the guards. Webb's an All-American, and Buchanan at center. Second down, Davis keeps the football, and Davis gets inside the 45-yard line. Dan Jellick, number 81 at left end. Jeff Perlinger, 97. Tim Davis, the good middle guard, 56. Mo Morton, 77, the right tackle. Mike Holmes, 40, the right end. Calvin O'Neill, 96, one linebacker. Dave Devich, 55, another. Wolfman is Don Dufek, number 35. We'll give you the deep men in a moment. Third down, short yardage. Washington hit. Does not have the first down. It'll be fourth down at the 43.
I can understand why they don't work on it too hard.
Owens under no pressure there, but gets the ball. Back to Dwight Hicks, and the ball goes into the end zone. That's Jim Smith in motion. Lytle carrying the football. They have gotten a yard. This is now out of school. Second down, and Leach is going to the air again, putting it out here and over the head of Keith Johnson.
Putting that pressure makes it tough on a quarterback.
Leach throwing on third down, 9. If he can get it away, that does not. So Jimbo Elrod also putting on the pressure. John Anderson to get the ball away. Fair catch called for by number one Zach Henderson at the 49-yard line.
But I'd like to know how she raised him, because she seems to have the answer.
That's Mo Morton, number 77. Oklahoma hasn't thrown yet. Davis hands off to Luttrell, the fullback. Third down and 13. Davis back for his first pass. If he can get it away, a dangerous runner. Down he goes, caught from behind, and there's that man again, Mo Morton, number 77. Owens lines this one.
Catch the ball!
Well, they're not going to touch that, and Oklahoma's going to get an excellent punt out of that inside the 10 down to about the 6-yard line. Huddle up the Wolverine. Lighter. About a couple of yards up to the 7-yard line. That's Gordy Bell, and he just gets back to the line of scrimmage. And Gene Johnson comes out. Straight up the middle goes Lytle. Schmurgy, 82. Gene Johnson, 88. Two tight ends are in there. And Gordy Bell. Oh, flag goes down as Bell goes down. First down and 19. Gordy Bell finds his way across the 10-yard line. Others may argue, but that's what Coach Switzer said. Lytle across the 15. Not only can they play football, but they are excellent students at Norman. Third down and 9. Leach keeps the ball himself, turns upfield. He's got the first down and more. Rick Leach has the first down across the 30-yard line. First man through is Lytle again.
Impressive.
Second down and 7. Leach, look out. Cornerback coming in, and Leach turns it upfield. Brown was coming in and pursued him upfield, but first down. Now it's first down at their 45. Rick Leach, nobody to throw it to, and he's got another first down, I believe. And Lytle with the football has the first down, and Jim Smith is flanked to the left. Now in motion. Gordy Bell. Oh, what a play. Michigan's only been to the Rose Bowl before today, won 4 out of their 6 appearances. Rick Leach still has the football, looking downfield for Johnson, off his hands and out of bounds. On the quick count, Leach back under tremendous pressure, gets away, gets a block.
Oh,
across the 40 and down near the first down. It all depends on where they mark it.
He's got it.
Fourth and inches. Well, somebody move. Question is, offense or defense? Will tell us. Motion there. Anderson now backs up inside the 10. Nobody is rushing. And Anderson hangs it high and short. Beautiful. They're down there. Let's see if they can down it before it goes into the end zone. And they do on the 1-foot line. John Anderson puts it down to the 1-foot line. With John Brody, Jim Simpson, we're both in the Orange Bowl, and so are Michigan and Oklahoma and about 80,000 others. First down from the 1. That's Steve Davis getting a couple of yards out to the 3. That's Steve Davis again. And Davis, I believe, has got the first down. Davis with the football has the first down out to the 20-yard line. And now Davis hangs on to the football and gets a couple of yards only. All right, that's the end of the first quarter. Everybody here, and I'm sure you know, the national championship is at stake. But at the end of a quarter, neither team has come close to scoring. It's nothing, nothing. Goes to Steve Davis on every play, telling him what it is he wants. There goes Luttrell across the 35, first down for the Sooners. Baker Owens and now Elvis Peacock both come wide right. On first down, Joe Washington with the football out to the 39-yard line. Second down, Davis is back to throw and looking for Tinker Owens. He's got it midfield, out of bounds.
All the equipment.
The throw carried, flag is down. Motion charged against Oklahoma. Trell again, the fullback, and still on his feet as he gets out to the 48-yard line. Second down and 12. Latrell again.
Line pitching the ball to the open man, and it makes it a little tougher.
Victor Hicks is now wide to the left, and Davis is going back to throw, setting up the screen if he can. Almost intercepted by Perlinger across the way. Jim Smith, the deep man, the rush is on, and he gets it away. Smith says, I want a fair catch. They're all around him there. Here's Jim Smith. Smith breaks out across the 30-yard line. And Gordy Bell has a little hole and makes the best of it. Still on his feet. First down across the 40. Low score in this ball game. The ball is down to 42. First man through, and boy, can he move. That's Lytle, who was a tailback. Second down 5 from the Michigan 47. Leach dropping back, looking across for Smith. Oh, he almost made a great catch, but was hit by Zach Henderson. We've seen it in the air plenty often. Third and 5. Rick Leach, Gordy Bell. Bell cuts inside. Bell, dragged down by Jimbo Elrod, does not have the first down at the 49-yard line. Zach Henderson is back with Washington. Rush is not on. Gets away a fine kick. Joe Washington back at the 10. Reversing field, flag goes down, and Washington goes down inside the 10-yard line. It's a clip. Luttrell, the first man through. Second down, 10. There's Davis going down near the goal line. Wow.
For a little Joe Washington quick kick.
Yep. That's what you're going to get. Ready for it. With number 17, Hicks. And Hicks with excellent coverage. 8:45 to go in the half. Nobody's come close to scoring yet. First man through is Lytle, and Lytle gets down to the 35-yard. They won game, and that was in 75 to Kansas. Oh, right off Anthony Bryant, number 71, goes Gordy Bell, and Bell, number 85. And Gene Johnson comes out. Keith Johnson and Jim Smith both wide to the left. Leach. Passing all the way, looking for Jim Smith. Catch it to it. Zuber will hold, and Bob Wood will attempt a 51-yard field goal. And that is going to be way short, but will make it into the end zone, and thus will come out to the 20-yard line. First down and 10. Challenges. First down 10. Here's Steve Davis pitching out to Joe Washington, and Washington rambles out near the 30-yard line. Michigan has had 35. Luttrell. Gets the ball near the first down. Victor Hicks, tight end, is on this side. Davis has the first down.
Steve just falls on in there.
Davis going for Tinker Owens. He's got it. Second catch of the night. First down. They haven't had too many of those second
against the red team.
Or third and twos. Holding his charge. The ball goes back to the 18-yard line. There's Luttrell. One. All the way, he's to pass and puts it out there for Owens. Oh, my, what a catch. Tinker Owens makes one of those All-American catches. Better replace Owens. And here's Brooks in the backfield getting away. Gets a great block across the 30. Brooks scores. 39-yard run. Oklahoma draws first blood.
Jimmy, that was something. The impressive thing about it is Michigan had a defense. They weren't as fooled as they were out executed. They had a man coming around the corner looking for him. He just absolutely juked him, and when he did, it set up the whole wall, ran it right in. That's a beautiful execution. Let's take a look. It's supposed to look like a wishbone play out to Peacock, who still hasn't carried the ball. The this isn't too bad right here. Brooks cuts up, gets right between Webb. Superb play.
Billy Brooks, the senior from Austin, Texas, a 39-yard run.
We're going to see it again, and I got to bet 2-1 he scores this time also. Just outdid the play itself. That's, I think those great athletes can't make a nice play look great.
Davis the hole, and Tony DiRienzo puts it through. 5:07 to go. We are in the first half, and Oklahoma looking for the national title has scored first and leads Michigan 7-0. To Owens and the reverse to Brooks as Tony DiRienzo kicks it off, and Gordy Bell at the 1 yard line. 10. Bell gets across the 20. Rick Leach turns it upfield, and not much running room at all. Leach cuts inside Jimbo Elrod and gets out to the 30-yard line. Going deep into the end zone, Leach back to throw now for Johnson, and that will be out of bounds. Anderson gets away a fine kick, sending Joe Washington back inside his own 25-yard line, where he drops the football, still loose, and falls on it at the 20-yard line. As Billy Brooks comes wide to the right. Luttrell gets across the 20-yard line, where he's wrestled down by 3 or 4 all year round. Davis pitching back. Elvis Peacock got his chance. On third down, Davis back to throw. Cannot get away, does not get the first down, and Oklahoma will have to kick it back to Michigan. Michigan, a lot of people up front. Gets the kick away. And is taken by Dwight Hicks. Hicks is across the 45 to the 48-yard line. Rick Leach pitching back to Jim Smith and fooling nobody. And Zach Henderson is playing center field in that Oklahoma defense. Leach putting it up for Smith. Over his head and off the hands of number 17, Jerry Anderson. And Leach back to throw. Under pressure from Leroy, and now goes out of bounds. And what? Beautiful kick. Joe Washington says, I'll have a fair catch as it bounces inside the 10-yard line and will go out of bounds, I do believe, at the 11. Flag goes down as Luttrell carries the football for not much.
Got the offensive left hand on the red team beating the snap.
Way this year for them, too, Jim.
Steve Davis, and down he goes. Michigan would like one more shot at the football in this half. Davis handing off to Elvis Peacock. Peacock knocked out of bounds, which stops the clock. He did. Dwight Hicks downfield. Ball is very short, and Michigan may have a shot because they're right down near the 30-yard line. Oh, Dewey Selman didn't like that. He came across and hit the man and then walked 10 yards deep in Stevenson to the right. First down and 5. Elzinger back to throw, has the time and looking, and it is incomplete. And second down 5. Elzinger's going to put it up again. Oh, he's wide open, Smith. And he overthrew him as he walked right into the coverage of number 17, Anderson. And Michigan, with 6 seconds to go, would like to get something on the board. They've come close tonight, but Oklahoma's the only team that has scored. And there's no doubt about that. And Billy Brooks rambled those 39 yards. From 43 yards out, and it is not going to be enough. And the half ends, and you've got the score. Rick Leach is in the dressing room. Michigan goes to the dressing room with no score, but Oklahoma with the possibility of winning the national championship tonight, since Ohio State lost, leads 7-0. Taken by one of the up men, and that is Luttrell, and Luttrell is across the 35-yard line and up to the 38. Howard, Hicks, and Pickens, the deep men. Joe Washington and hemmed in as he gets to the 40-yard line. Pitch out to Peacock. Calvin O'Neill is there and makes the stop as the flag goes down at the 38-yard line. And here's Pete Williams. Holding charge against Oklahoma, about 24. Go Washington.
Oh,
fine play made by Dan Jellick. Number one to the right, Jim Bolden over there with him. Steve Davis going to run, apparently, and no, sir, he'll be knocked down at the 26-yard line.
Good job by everybody.
Orton Holmes made the stop as Owens kicks the ball away. White Hicks takes the fair catch at the 38-yard line. Eltinger cutting up and getting some tough yardage across the 40 to the 43. It is second down at about 5. 7-0 Oklahoma early in the second half. Morty Bell. Bell twists out near the first down on third down and short. And Elzinger may have taken too much time, and it'll be third down and about 6 instead of third and 1. And that's what happened.
I wonder how.
Third and about 6. Elzinger under tremendous pressure from Leroy Selman on his feet and does not have the first down, I don't believe. This is the 6th punt of the night for Anderson. It took a long time, but got it very high. Washington has to go for the fair catch and does in a crowd. A long way to go, and Michigan's awfully tough. Jeff Colbreth is in there now. That is guess who? From the 28. Colbreth has lost the football. Belongs to Michigan. Colbreth lost the football. Belongs to Michigan. Dan Jellick recovers at the 26-yard line. George Viskotsky is in for the first time tonight at tight end. Elzinger pitches back to Gordy Bell. Locker in front of him, and Bell gets down to the 20-yard line. Second down at about 4. Elzinger looks like a mix-up to me. No matter, he picks up a couple of yards, and they're working on his left shoulder. Third down, short yardage. Elzinger carries the football very close to the first down. As Jim Smith checked in. Elzinger keeps. He's got the first down, I do believe. And Johnson comes to the left. Elzinger keeps the football himself and gets down to the 12-yard line. Elzinger to Gordy Bell. Bell has some blocking and gets down inside the 9-yard. A quick pitch to Gordy Bell, trying to get around the corner. He throws. It's intercepted in the end zone by Sidney Brown, who's thrown out of bounds. He doesn't care. He knows the rule. Straight ahead goes Colbreth. Across the 30, first down at the 34.
Oh, boy.
Starting through Joe Washington across the 40 to the 42. Second down and 2. Second man through again, Joe Washington across the 45. First. Davis going to throw on first down and gets it out there. And there's the man again, Tinker Owens.
That's a tough way to have to cover a man.
Elvis Peacock of Miami takes the ball out of the 35. In the final voting. Luttrell. Ball is loose.
Okay.
Ball belongs to Michigan. Another fumble. Joe Washington fumbled the football. First down from a 34. Gordy Bell, he has been hamstrung most of the evening. He's been Elzinger in there.
Uh-oh.
Going back. Look out. Mark Elzinger gets the ball up and out of bounds. Elzinger, the junior filling in for the freshman Rick Leach, who has a concussion. Elzinger, look out. There he goes. Jimbo Elrod, Leroy Selman. Two All-Americans. They recovered the fumble at the 34. Another fine kick by Anderson. Joe Washington calls for the fair catch. At Orange Bowl here 1 year, and Penn State won it. 12 men on the field. Anderson gets this one away, shanking it off to the right, and it goes out of bounds inside the 35-yard line. Davis throwing on first down, or trying to, moving out, stepping inside beautifully across the line of scrimmage, and Calvin O'Neill makes the stop at the 40. And it's wide to the left. Colbert is the first man through, and he may have the first down. Gone to that football, and they've got the lead 7-0. Colbert. Fake to him. Davis with the football. Davis with another first down. Pitching out.
Pretty good play.
Oklahoma on the march at the 43. Alworth with the football, and now they're beginning to chew up huge chunks of them. Davis steps over one man and just does get back to the line of scrimmage. Steve Davis cuts inside. First down, Steve Davis inside. Ball is loose and knocked out of bounds, but into the left. First man through is Culbreth, and he gets down to about the 17-yard line. Davis have gone the whole way. Culbreth has been in there a little bit for Luttrell. Davis pitching up to Peacock, picks it up on the perfect bounce, and goes down to about the 1 or 2 yard line.
But the back trying to help out Elvis, and if so, it really takes him out of great field position.
Freshman from Lubbock, Texas, is told to get to the other side. Davis going straight back. Jellick is coming, hits him as he throws. Ball is knocked away beautifully by Hicks, intended for Brooks at the five. First down through Colbert. Look out, Dufek chasing him. Has him inside the 10. First down, Oklahoma. Oklahoma can go a long way toward a possible, and you might say probable, national championship if they can score here. Well, that's going to be the last play of this, the third quarter. That's it. Well, we'll come back to the Orange Bowl in Miami. It's a delightful night. It's a big game, and it's 7-0 Oklahoma with 15 minutes to go. Second down and 10 to go for Oklahoma. Steve Davis carrying the football, and Davis, he scores! Steve Davis makes it 13-0 Oklahoma on a 10-yard run.
Jim, they put that pressure on you all night long. Eventually, something's got to give. Steve's been running both sides of the line. I mentioned he likes to run the ball to the right. This, it seems like it makes no difference. He gets a lot of commitment, makes an excellent play, tippy-toes it in the end zone, and things are looking good down in Oklahoma.
It is good. 14 minutes, 56 seconds to go in the ball game, and Oklahoma, the Boomer Sooners, lead the Wolverines of Michigan 14-0. The Sooners of Oklahoma march 12 plays, 68 yards. Davis going over from 10 yards out. It's 14-0. So we've got nearly a quarter of football to go. Tony D will kick it off. Gordon Bell back near his own goal line, deep. It will be taken by the up man, Lytle. Lytle gets out across the 30-yard line. And now Rick Leach does come back in, and the Michigan fans see it. Jim Smith cutting inside and gets about 4 yards to the as a receiver for the Michigan Wolverines. Pitch back. Gordy Bell turning upfield. Oh, my, what an exciting runner. Third down of the yard when it's 14-0. Nothing hurts. Leach turns it himself and has the first down. Leach still on his feet. Sidney Brown makes the stop at midfield.
Bet there is. This game is a long way from over.
Jim Smith in motion. First down, and he throws the ball away, and Gordy Bell gets on it at the 35-yard line. Spread ahead. Leach. Going to run, but he's got a long way to go, and isn't going to make it. As he gets out to the 45-yard line, it's fourth down at about 15 to go. Anderson stepping on his own 31-yard line. Time. Gets the boot away.
This
the Washington is going to try to run it back. Going up that right side. And down he goes. At about the 21-yard line. Ball is loose. Oklahoma on it. Clip is called against Oklahoma. Tinker Owens wide left. Lee Davis pitching out and running out of bounds to Joe Washington. Oh, way back. Steve Davis wrestled down by Perlinger. Owens in his own end zone. High pass from center. Gets the ball away. Not very far. But it is picked up by Hicks and down he goes. Rick Leach is in there. Gordy Bell trying to get something going. Selman Dewey trailed him all the way for Oklahoma. There is Gordy Bell breaking into the secondary and has the first down. Here comes Jim Smith, and there is Jimbo Elrod. Michigan 0 for 11. Second down and 14 to go, and Leach is going to try to complete one here. Throwing it down and way out of bounds across the way, intended for Keith Johnson. Leach, as the time delivers, and it is over the head of everybody. Fewest points they've had this year, 14. But they have none so far tonight. All down by Lytle. Joe Washington in the end zone, trying to get out of the end zone, and
oh,
he got out. That's the one. Second at 11. A lot of time left, 7:17. Oh, ball is loose.
Oh, my.
Now wait for the officials. That's Michigan. Now they say Michigan has got the ball on the two. First and goal to go from the two. At 7:09 left in the game. Gordy Bell, touchdown.
How many of these kind have you seen before? That's a long 2 yards down by that goal line, and Gordy made most of those on his own. Now we'll see which way they're going to go, whether they're going to go for the two or the one.
I would assume that I don't know. So I'm going
to
wait.
I think they're going for the two, because if they don't make it, they've still got an opportunity the next time to go
around
for two to tie it, rather than putting too much of a burden on them to make 2 points if they get close enough on the next touchdown. That's assuming an awful lot, but that's the way it looks.
Bob Woods got in there. They're lined up, so they are going to go for the two. Leach follows the interference, and Leach is stopped short. And it's 14-6. 7:06 to go. UCLA feeling pretty good after what they did today. Onside kick. Go for the football, and it belongs to Oklahoma out at the 46-yard line. That's Joe Washington. Washington held to a yard or two. There's Joe Washington. Washington's got the first down, and he. Steve Davis. Had a lot of folks over there, aren't there? Including, look at that. Joe Washington's broken that record. Here comes Peacock. Calvin is there, and Calvin O'Neill made the play. Third down, about 13 to go. Straight ahead, throws the fullback culprit. White Hicks is the deep man. Rushes on. He got it away. The ball is going down toward the end zone and into the end zone. Elzinger is the quarterback. Rick Leach again on the bench with an injury. Elzinger back to throw on first down. Gets the ball away and overshoots. Second down 10. Straight ahead. Most Lytle. Gordy Bell, and he's not going to get anywhere near the first down. Anderson gets away, a beauty. Beauty. Joe Washington deep and takes it at the 30-yard line. That's Colbert getting away from Morton. Joe Washington turning the corner and has got the first down.
As much this year as he has in the previous two.
There he goes, Joe Washington cutting inside. Still on his feet. What a move, and finally dragged down by Devich. First down. Davis hands off to Culbert, and Culbert gets down to the 40-yard line. Second down at about 8. Steve Davis across the 35, pitching back to Peacock. Down goes an official. Fullback, and we'll listen to
illegal procedure against number 66 of the red team.
Michigan hoping for the big turnover. Oklahoma just wanting to move the football and run down the clock.
Oh!
Look at Joe Washington. He went into the line.
Howie, I can tell you.
Pitch back to Joe Washington. They're converging on him. And it's going to be fourth down as he.
Let's hear from Paul Quinn.
Rushes on Tinker Owens, and he gets the ball away. And this ball will go into the end zone. They've got 93 yards to go, and then they must get the two to tie. Leach turns it upfield across the 10, and Leach is out across the 15-yard line. 59 seconds left. They haven't completed the pass yet. Leach puts it up and cannot complete this one. Say that Oklahoma's got a big, long leg up on the possibility. Leach hands off to Gordy Bell. First down, Leach under pressure, and down he goes. Clock continues to run. Now they call time with 42 seconds left. It's 14-6. Leach, second down, has to put it up. Ellie's completed one to Gordy Bell. Bell, nifty, running out across the 30 down in collegiate football.
This is where you can tell, Jim, just how well a team is groomed to play in this last minute of a ball game. They have no seconds to lose. They've only got 27 left.
Leach doesn't know where to unload it, and does unload it to Keith Johnson from their own 49-yard line. Leach back to throw again. Excellent protection. Drills the ball. Incomplete. Stop.
An illegal delay against the white team.
Jerry Reese. Another defensive back has come in for Oklahoma. Under pressure, he throws for Smith, and the ball is almost intercepted by Oklahoma. Back off probation, taking a shot at the national title. Third down, 5 seconds to go. Leach back to throw. Leach puts it up, and it is intercepted. Down the field by Scott Hill. Time has run out. As Hill goes down, Oklahoma has won 14-6. They'll be voting in the coming week to see who is the national champion. Barry Switzer's group did an outstanding job with Billy Brooks and Steve Davis scoring the touchdowns on runs of 39 and 10 yards, and the fumble set up to Gordy Bell, 2-yard touchdown burst. Tonight, Oklahoma, well, I'll quote one of the words you use, John Brody, awesome.